In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus Christ, with the fellowship of Reverend Father Xavier, who is the founder of the Anointing Fire Catholic Ministries, I welcome all of you into this episode of Thunder of God. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Before we begin, let's worship God together. Kindly stand up. Let's praise our God. Hallelujah. Praise
Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Powerful intercession of our mother. Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Please be seated. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today we are going to see the topic that is mourning and anointing, or lamenting and anointing. That means lament and to get anointed. The basic text is Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 5, verse 4. Let's read. If you have a Bible, join with them in reading. Yeah.
Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted.
Yeah. Actually, who is a mourner? Who is a lamenter? In order to understand who is a lamenter, who is a mourner, the easy way is to go through the origin of monastic life. As you know, monastic life got originated in Egyptian deserts. What was the reason behind its origin? You see, some people got inspired to live in the world as if not of the world. And those who got such inspiration withdrew from this world and lived together in Egyptian deserts. That was the beginning of monastic life. Among such monasteries, one is known as mourning monks or lamenting monks. Even today, if you search on the net, you can see that. Today also it is prevailing. Why are they called lamenting monks or mourning monks? By seeing the world is moving to destruction, sin is creeping into the church, the perishing youth, they cried before God. They lament. They cried before God for his perishing people. Then church called them as mourning monks or lamenting monks. So my dear brothers and sisters, who is a mourner? Who is a lamenter? It is a deep, heartfelt lamentation of a righteous man, the chosen man, by seeing the atrocities, the destruction of this world. You see, all the chosen ones in the Bible prayed with mourning. We shall begin with the New Testament, and we will go to the Old Testament, and we will see some of the examples. Please take 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 21.
I fear that when I come again, my God may humble me before you, and that I may have to mourn over many who previously sinned and have not repented of the impurity, sexual immorality, and licentiousness that they have practiced.
Yeah. My dear brothers and sisters, what does it mean? Actually, St. Paul wishes to visit the churches which is started by him. That was known as St. Paul's missionary journeys. Before going to the church of Corinth, he wrote a letter to them. In that letter, he mentioned like this: when I reach there, sometimes I have to mourn again, lament again. So, what is the meaning of this? The destruction and annihilation of the people because the deep pain of a Christian, a chosen one, that is mourning, lament. So, my dear brothers and sisters, we should feel pain when people leading an immoral life. Actually, my Christian life is to mourn, to pray over the people, over my people. We can see some of the examples from the Old Testament. Book of Nehemiah chapter 1, verse 1 to 4. Book of Nehemiah chapter 1, verse 1 to 4.
The words of Nehemiah, son of Hakaliah, in the month of Chislev, in the 20th year, while I was in Susa, the capital, one of my brothers, Hanani, came with certain men from Judah. And I asked them about the Jews that survived, those who had escaped the captivity, and about Jerusalem. They replied, "The survivors there in the province who escaped captivity are in great trouble and shame. The wall of Jerusalem is broken down, and its gates have been destroyed by fire." When I heard these words, I sat down and wept and mourned for days, fasting and praying before the God of heaven.
Yeah, you just hear one more, the verse 4.
When I heard these words, I sat down and wept and mourned for days, fasting and praying before the God of heaven.
Yeah, you see, you know the context. Actually, it was the period of captivity. As you know, when people of God go to captivity, if there is a prophet, a chosen one, or priest, or king, or judge is there, they are also supposed to go to the captivity, even if they have not committed sin. That means the chosen one, the Christian, must suffer along with the people. Here, You see, Nehemiah and his household, his wife, his children, his family members, along with the people, went to captivity. Usually, the slaves worked in brick field on paddy field. But here, Nehemiah got a job which is a bit better than the ordinary slaves. That is, he had to walk behind the king by holding his cup. He was appointed as the cupbearer. And a person called Hananiah, he came to meet Nehemiah from the captivity. Naturally, what he would have asked as his meeting after a long time, he would have asked whether his parents are alive. What is about the situation of my wife, my children? But he never asked such a question. But he asked, what is the position of my people? What is the situation of my people? He was very eager to know the situation of his people. And you see, Hananiah replied, the wall of Jerusalem is broken and gates were destroyed by fire. No one renewed it. And we may not escape from the captivity. Hearing this news, what Nehemiah do? When I heard these words, I sat down and wept and mourned for days and fasted and prayed. See, by seeing the problem of the people, he can't bear. He wept down. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Now, we are going to see why the mourners are blessed, why the lamenters are blessed. In order to understand why they are blessed, we have to go to book of Ezekiel. Book of Ezekiel, chapter 9, verse 3 to 4. Read together.
Now the glory of the God of Israel had gone up from the cherub on which it rested to the threshold of the house. The Lord called to the man clothed in linen who had the writing case at his side and said to him, go through the city, through Jerusalem, and put a mark on the foreheads of those who sigh and groan over all the abominations that are committed in it.
Yeah, God called a messenger and said to him, go to the city of Jerusalem. And when you go through the city of Jerusalem, you have to look down each one's face. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
If you see anybody is lamenting or mourning for the souls, for the destruction, we have to put mark on their forehead. You see, of course, when the messenger passed through, he might have put a mark on the forehead of Nehemiah, on the forehead of St. Paul. You see, in the Bible, put a mark on the forehead means belongs to God. This meaning in the Bible. Where do we see that the Bible is putting a mark? Book of Genesis chapter 4, God put a mark on the forehead of Cain. That means Cain belongs to God. Through circumcision, God marked Abraham, Moses, which means they belong to God, they're men of God. The next example is that gave mark on the doorpost of Israelites with the blood of Lamb. That means this house is of God. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Next, we can see in the book of Revelation, there we can see that an angel is allowing the people to enter into heaven. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Then Lord said to that angel, when the people are coming to you, you have to look on their forehead. If you have mark, if you see a mark on their forehead, allow them to reach into heaven. Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now you know the meaning why mourners are blessed. Because they are of heaven. Their salvation is sure. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 You know, how did Monica become Saint Monica? For 34 years, she cried before God for the conversion of his son, Augustine. Then what happened? Augustine became Saint Augustine and said to Monica, blessed is she who mourned, and she became Saint Monica. You see, how did Saint Little Flower, called as Doctor of the Church, only because of her mourning for the souls. Say hallelujah.
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 Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So my dear brothers and sisters, we should have pain for the souls. Then we have to weep and pray. Then definitely it will increase our anointing. That means our salvation is sure. Our soul is of God, of heaven. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And my dear brothers and sisters, lament and get anointed. Mourners are blessed. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Kindly stand up. Let us open our hands towards God and close our eyes and pray to God. Oh Lord, give me the pain to pray for the soul. Let's pray in silence. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Raise our hands towards Eucharistic Lord and praise our God with a louder voice. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father.
Hallelujah.
Praise you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Holy Spirit, anoint us. Holy Spirit, touch us.
Hallelujah.
Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. We praise you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. We glorify your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Heal us, O Lord. Heal us, O Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh Lord Jesus, when we stand before you, we offer ourselves to you in front of you. Lord Jesus, my heart is a wounded heart. I need healing. Lord Jesus, all the bitter experience of my past life made me a person of uncontrolled anger, jealous, hurtful, and lust. Lord Jesus, I can't love myself. My personality is a wounded personality. Jesus, only you can love me. I am revealing before you as I am. Lord Jesus, come and touch me. Heal me, Jesus.
Divine.
God, blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus, the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and his angels and in his saints.